So now we're going to move on to editing. So I'll just promote a few of them. So Audacity is a really good open source editing software for audio. So is GarageBand. We have made a few resources which are on this slide on GarageBand. So that goes through everything that you'll need to know about GarageBand. So it just goes up from how to set up GarageBand, how to record, so you can actually record using GarageBand, how to remove noise, how to fade in and out, which will be very useful when you're doing podcasting, how to trim clips, how to source stock sound effects and music. We'll go through that in a bit of detail later, but these videos are all available for you to watch whenever you're ready to sort of start editing. If you do want to add some music and things, it just goes through in detail everything that you need to do in order to do that. So just going back to the presentation. So Audacity and GarageBand are the main ones we'll recommend. Audition is what I use. So as a production sort of person, Audition is fantastic. The only issue with Audition is that there's a bit of a learning curve to learn it. And it looks really complex when you first get it started, but you can sort of, if you did want to take that extra step, you can learn Audition. We don't have any tutorials available that we've made, but there are plenty of tutorials online if you did want to learn Audition. The other three that are on this page are actually video editing software. So Adobe Rush is accessible if you have an Adobe Creative Cloud account. So Adobe Rush is kind of good because if you do want to use video as well as your audio, you can do that. The audio ducking feature is really good on Adobe Rush. So an audio ducking is basically if you want to have one timeline of sort of, you know, audio and then music underneath that, it will automatically lower the volume of the music so that the audio of the person speaking is prevalent. So that's a really good feature in Adobe Rush if you did want to use that. iMovie is good. It's for Macs, so it comes pre-installed in most Macs. KDenLive is a good editor that's available for Mac, PC and Linux. I'll just click on this page. This is a link to our website. And the great thing about this is that there are tutorials for everything that I've just mentioned. So we have playlists with multiple videos. This is how to trim on your phone if you just want to trim a few clips on your phone. So if you did want to use iMovie, there's heaps of tutorials. There's tutorials here on KDenLive. So this is just specifically for video editing. But as I mentioned, we've got those tutorials on GarageBand through the other link that I... If you do want some information about Creative Cloud, there is some information about how to access it. So the good news is that every staff member at RMIT has access to Creative Cloud. Unfortunately, only select students have access, but some have access through the course, but not everyone. So that's basically editing. As I mentioned, there's the GarageBand tutorials. Those are really good if you did want to use GarageBand. We do have some tutorials here on how to remove noise. So that's sort of like what you'd want to do, number one, when you're editing is just remove some of the background noise that will just be there. It might be aircon, it might just be ambient noise that's coming in. So if you want to do that, Audacity can do it on a Mac or a PC or Linux. GarageBand can do it for a Mac. So there's tutorials there for you to watch when you're ready.